Maria Hergueta for Spectrum. For a time, Nikki Lower had all the help she needed. Although she said she often felt she didn't quite fit in during high school, she worked hard and excelled academically. After graduation, Lower did some volunteer work, but the stress of that work, and some social difficulties, led her to a therapist, who diagnosed her with depression and anxiety. The therapist also saw signs of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. When Lower gained admission to Brigham Young University in Utah, the university made accommodations, such as reserved seating in classes, audio texts and an electronic notebook for taking notes. For a few semesters, Lower did well. But as her classes became more difficult, she struggled with time management, motivation and severe anxiety, and her grades dropped. She also noticed that her roommates were much better at making friends than she was, and she felt left out. She wondered if there might be another explanation for her difficulties. After an evaluation, we diagnosed her with autism. Lower began attending group therapy sessions for students with autism, and she finally began to feel confident that she could succeed at the university. More than 44% of students with autism receive some type of post-secondary education in the United States. People with autism make up 1-2% of students in universities. This number includes many cognitively able students, such as Lower, who find it difficult to adapt to university life because of social, emotional and organizational challenges. As a result of these obstacles, the graduation rate of U.S. students with autism or another disability is 41%, compared with 59% in the general population. An understanding of the needs of students with autism, along with support for their difficulties, can go a long way toward helping them succeed in institutions of higher education. Expert panels have identified mental health as a top priority for helping adults with autism. In an ongoing survey by researchers at Durham University in Britain, university students with autism report that mental health concerns and social isolation are the biggest challenges they face. Both issues are also risk factors for suicide. Like Lower, many adults with autism struggle with the organizational and planning skills that fall under the umbrella of executive function. These struggles become more problematic when young adults begin living apart from their parents and when they need to adapt to classes with less structure than in high school. The sightsiness of university dining halls, parties in the dormitories and crowded campuses can overstimulate and overwhelm them. Those who have sensory difficulties may struggle to study or socialize in these environments. In large institutions, these problems can easily be missed by everyone, including the parents of these students. Fortunately, solutions may be at hand. In August, we published an analysis of 2 decades of client records from the Counseling and Psychological Services Center at Brigham Young University. Among those records are questionnaires that students filled out before and after therapy. The center follows standard evidence-based counseling approaches but has no unique protocol for students with autism. The records suggest that before treatment, students with and without autism show comparable levels of psychological distress. They also report a similar degree of improvement after treatment. But to achieve such gains, those in the autism group take about twice as long, including significantly more therapy sessions, than do their peers without autism. So students with autism can benefit from standard counseling but may require more of it. Many higher education providers offer support networks intended for people with autism, such as the therapy group that Lower attended. There are also a growing number of programs that help young adults with the condition transition from high school to vocational training or a university. For example, Utah Valley University, the state's largest higher education institution, received a grant to jumpstart a program for students with autism that includes weekly meetings to build skills, recreational and social activities, and regular workshops for families. Universities can also adapt existing services to meet the needs of adults with autism. For instance, many institutions already provide aids for students with learning challenges. Some of these aides could be trained to be executive function coaches. Student mentors also can provide excellent support for adults on the spectrum. It may be possible to create safe spaces, areas with minimal sensory stimulation, for taking exams and other activities. And our data suggest that extending treatment for people with autism can lead to substantial improvements in well-being while decreasing costs associated with student failure. Generating the institutional willpower to improve support for students on the spectrum requires advocacy, creativity, and flexibility. Administrators and others should take the time to learn about autism and push for change. Autism is not rare. Every college has many students with autism who can succeed with a little help. Cox is an associate clinical professor of counseling and psychological services at Brigham Young University, where South is an associate professor of psychology and neuroscience. This article is excerpted from one originally published on Spectrum, which focuses on autism research.